will need to show proof of vaccination or a recent COVID-19 test to enter some businesses. That new measure, part of the latest Oahu Safe Access Program. And we know a lot of people have questions about it. So to break it all down for us, how it all works, where it'll be in place, is Ryan Ozawa, Director of Communication at Hawaii Information Service. Good morning, Ryan.
Good morning. Great to be here.
Absolutely. So, I mean, tomorrow's kind of the big day. You know, even if people are vaccinated and, you know, have that information, there's kind of a lot of confusion. And the first of which, you know, we keep calling it an app, but it's technically not. It's actually a section of the website, right?
Right. A lot of software developers will say, well, it's a web app, but I think the typical understanding of an app is an icon on your smartphone. And in this case, it's a website. It's a web presentation. So, and it's what's even more interesting is that it's part of the travel safe program that the state does, but it's actually not valid for travel either. But I think that's the site where they had the most resources and agility to implement something like this quickly.
So how does it work? So you still have to go onto the website, you upload it, and then it's not on that website, right? You'd have to then screenshot it, or how does that work?
Well, first of all, you need to have an account on the travel.hawaii.gov website. So before you click on that wonderful button that says you want to do your smart health card, you actually have to set up a profile for yourself or your family members as if you were going to travel. So that's also another concern that people might be missing. And then when you set it up and you click on the smart health card icon, you're just prompted to enter all the information from your paper card. And it checks against a registry of vaccination information from most large vaccine providers, but not all of them. And if it passes, it gives you a QR code, which is those two-dimensional barcodes. Apart from that, you don't need to keep the website open or always use the website. You can screenshot it and just keep it in your photo album. You can make it your wallpaper if you're going to use it often. You can even print it out, believe it or not. One of the reasons why they implemented this is because a two-dimensional QR code, a barcode, is more private in the sense that regular humans can't read them. So while you can read the details on one of these cards, an average person can't necessarily see the details in one of those codes.
So, you know, because they do give people the option of show the physical card, you can show a picture of the card, you can do this QR code. Just from a safety perspective, you know, which of those would you recommend?
Well, I like the smart health card process. I like that it does check against records. I mean, certainly this is not hard to counterfeit. Also, these are hard to take care of. They don't fit in your wallet. I've seen some pretty sad cards out there now that they've been in circulation quite a bit. And the other reason why you might want to do that is that they're planning or hoping to expand the smart health card system. Right now, it just does vaccination status, but the hope is that you can also put negative test results using the same system.
And, you know, and that's one thing for the customers, but also, you know, we hear from businesses, you know, I want to be in compliance. How do I check this? Is the QR code system easier for them too because they can just scan it?
Yes, if they have a smartphone or an iPad with a camera on it, the reader app, and that's an actual app on your phone, is free. And all it basically does is scan that QR code and return very basic information. This is a valid record, and it puts the name. It doesn't show any private information like your birth date or anything like that. So it might be preferable for some businesses and for individuals, customers. Of course, anybody could use anybody else's QR code, so you'll want to check it against their identification.
And is there anything that you foresee them maybe improving on this in the future? Because, I mean, it seems, you know, with the pandemic not going away, it's more and more places are going to start requiring this, and it's going to be so commonplace. It seems kind of convoluted to have to keep screenshotting and this. You know, do you think eventually they'll make some upgrades?
Well, fortunately, the QR codes currently don't expire, which is good. The other upgrades that you'll want to see, of course, in addition to your negative test result, which is another way that perhaps this could be implemented if you don't have a vaccine, and the other piece is that it's on the travel website, but it's not valid for travel. I think the hope is that will get there eventually, and you can have one repository. There's never going to be one single app to cover everything, and the U.S. government has said that this is as far as they're going to go as far as an official program using the paper cards. So we're going to have to look to technology to make everything simpler and all in one.
Yeah, you know, it's just so surprising, you know, when this first came out, it's just, you know, a paper card, you know, it was kind of surprised it wasn't this to begin with.
Yeah, and I think it's the government understands the hesitations people have about a single database or a single app or having the government directly involved. The great thing about this smart health card and other protocols like IBM has one, and Clear, of course, the travel app, is that you have a choice. You don't have to use any of these solutions as long as you're okay with your paper card. But I think it's reasonable to be suspicious of a single database. So this is the world we're in.
Yeah, definitely. And we appreciate you breaking it all down for us, Ryan. Thanks so much.
Always a pleasure. Thank you.
Absolutely. And again, that all starts tomorrow. Once those new rules go into effect, we'll have that full interview for you at KITV.com. For now, we're off for a break. Time now, 6:51. You're watching Good Morning Hawaii. We'll be right back.